In the name of the Father and of the Son of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary.
And she conceived of the Holy Spirit.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Behold the handmaid of the Lord.
Be it unto me according to your word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
And the Word was made flesh.
And dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are thee among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ your Son was made known by the message of an angel, may be brought by his passion across to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Just like a child who trusts his father and who delights to feel his presence near. Just like a child whose mind has not yet dulled and whose heart is never proud. Here I come, O Lord, here I come just like a child. Here I come, O Lord. Here I come just like a child. Just like a child, so weak he cannot stand, but to hold firm and tight his mother's hand. Just like a child who sing his bright delight, fearing not the long dark night. Here I come, O Lord, here I come just like a child. Here I come, O Lord, here I come just like a child.
If you, O Lord, should mark iniquities, Lord, who would stand? But with you is found forgiveness, O God of Israel. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of the Lord, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Walking with the Lord is the call. Being with the Lord is the intimacy, spreading the word of God is an honor given to all of us. We, the priests and religious, are said to be the privileged ones, for we are called to adhere to Him to the best of our abilities, given every opportunity, given every honor, and above all, to lay life for the very call. Let us at this time thank God for the blessing and the call, and at the same time ask the Lord for all the moments where we have not been keen in following the Lord, instead tried our best to meet our own needs, desires and preoccupations. Let us ask God to forgive, so that we may gain strength and may we root ourselves again firmly in Him who is Lord and Master. I confess to Almighty God
and you, my brothers and sisters,
to pray for great listen
in my thoughts and in my words,
in what I have done
and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May the Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. May your grace, O Lord, we pray, at all times go before us and follow after, and make us always determined to carry out good works. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
First reading, a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. The man is justified on faith, and not by doing something in the law tells him to do. God's justice that was made known through the law and the prophet has now been revealed outside the law, since it is the same justice of God that comes through faith to everyone, Jews and pagans alike, who believes in Jesus Christ. Both Jews and pagans have sinned and forfeited God's glory, and both are justified through the free gift of His grace by being redeemed in Christ Jesus, who was appointed by God to sacrifice His life so as to win reconciliation through faith. In this way, God made His justice known, first for the past, when sins went unpunished because He held His hand, then for the present age, by showing positively that He is just, and that He justifies everyone who believes in Jesus. So what becomes of our boasts? There is no room for them. What sort of law excludes them? The sort of law that tells us what to do. On the contrary, it is the law of faith, since as He sees it, A man is justified by faith and not by doing something the law tells him to do. Is God the God of the Jews alone and none of the pagans too? Of the pagans too, most certainly, since there is only one God. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Your response. With the Lord there is mercy.
With the Lord there is mercy.
And fullness of redemption. Out of the depths I cry to you, O Lord. Lord, hear my voice. O let your ears be attentive to the voice of my pleading. Your response. With the Lord there is mercy.
With the Lord there is mercy.
And fullness of redemption. If you, O Lord, should mark our gain, Lord, who would preserve him? But with you is found forgiveness. For this we rever you. A response. With the Lord there is mercy.
With the Lord there is mercy.
And fullness of redemption. My soul is waiting for the Lord. I count on his word. My soul is longing for the Lord, more than watchmen for daybreak. Response. With the Lord there is mercy.
With the Lord there is mercy.
And fullness of redemption. Gospel acclamation.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
I am the way, the truth, and the life, says the Lord. No one can come to the Father except through me. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Chapter 11, verses from 47 to 54. Gospel according to St. Luke, chapter 11, verses from 47 to 54. Jesus said, "Alas for you who build the tombs of the prophets, the men your ancestors killed. In this way you both witness what your ancestors did and approve it. They did the killing and you do the building. And that is why the wisdom of God said, 'I will send them prophets and apostles. Some they will slaughter and persecute, so that this generation will have to answer for every prophet's blood that has been shed since the foundation of the world, from the blood of Abel to the blood of Zechariah, who was murdered between the altar and the sanctuary. Yes, I tell you, this generation will have to answer for it all. Alas for you lawyers who have taken away the key of the knowledge. You have not gone in yourselves and have prevented others going in who wanted to.' When he left the house, the scribes and the Pharisees began furious attack on him and tried to force answers from him on innumerable questions, setting traps to catch him out in something he might say." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We have a moment where the disciples come and ask. The disciples of John are doing some miracles. And on another occasion, they complain some doing the miracles. And Jesus warns them and cautions them not to disturb, instead allow them to do. Jesus was allowing people of goodwill to do the good in their own manner. Today we have some occasion or some situation where things go contrary. Lawyers who are given the keys of knowledge, who are given the privilege, have failed to keep their honor or the designation that was entrusted or given in the society. Is the moment now to question and seek the Lord's assistance, for we are all vested with one power or the other. The very call to a priesthood or nunnery, or to be a parent, to be a teacher, and in various forms we assume power and honor and designation. And we are given this privilege to exercise everything that comes along with this power or the recognition in the society. Every title has some responsibility, some dignity which we are supposed to be upholding. And are we doing it to the best? And do we have queries if someone else is doing? And do we allow others to take part in the power that is given to us? Do we decentralize, or do we extend, or do we hold to us only? And are there moments where I do not do and I do not allow others to do? Just as the apostles had problem when someone else was doing wonders. Twice Jesus says, "Alas, alas for those who do not do, and yet we assume power." Let this day be a day where we reflect. Do we have the moments of finding fault with others, or do I introspect and see how am I faring with the call, with the position that I stand in? And let me not forget that I am accountable to the one who has given me. It is he who has the authority to ask me, and do I have answers? Let us for a moment ask the Lord for such grace. There were prophets who have given their best and at the same time laid their life, as said in the gospel, both from Abel to Zechariah. Are we ready to lay life for the call that we are blessed with? Or do we take refuge and do we gain only the privileges? Or are we ready to lay life?
We offer you, O Lord divine, our humble gifts of bread and wine. We place them on your altar, Lord, today. Make them worthy of your love. Send your blessings from above. Sanctify these gifts, O Lord, we pray. Oh, take our hearts, take our minds, take all we have, make them thine, O Lord, take all we for you, O Lord divine, our humble gifts of bread and wine. We place them all of the Lord today. Make them worthy of your love. Send your blessings from above. Sanctify these gifts, O Lord, we pray. Oh, take our heart, take our minds, take all we have, make them thine, O Lord, take all we have, make them thine.
Pray, dear friends, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept our sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Lord, we offer every thought of our heart while we thank for the privileges that we are given. May we be ready to sacrifice together with this bread and wine, so that we may be more acceptable with the works that we do and the thoughts that we entertain. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in goodness you created man, and when he was justly condemned, in mercy you redeemed him through Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heavens and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with this in humble praise as we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took the bread, giving you thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving you thanks, he gave the cup to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which shall be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Balaswami, the administrator, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep into the hope of resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, Saint Joseph, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, may we merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us all pray the words our Savior taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread.
Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
The Lamb who delivers us all from every sin, happy are we who have come to receive the Lord.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Full of my Savior, sanctify my soul. Body of Christ, be thou my saving guest.
Blood of my Savior, make me in thy joy. Wash me with waters gushing from thy side. Strength and protection may thy passion be. O blessed Jesus, hear and answer me. Deep in thy wounds, Lord, hide and shelter me. So shall I never part from thee. God, and defend me from the former line. In desperate moment, make me only thine. Call me and make me come to thee on high, where I may praise thee with the saints on high.
Let us pray. We entreat your majesty most humbly, O Lord, that you feed us with the nourishment which comes from the most holy body and blood of your Son, so you may make us sharers of divine nature, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let's all go in peace and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Acts 18. The mass is ended, I'll go in peace. We must diminish and Christ increase. We take him with us wherever we go, that through our actions his life may show. We witness his love to everyone by our communion with Christ the Son. We take the mass to where one may be, so Christ may shine forth for all to see. The mass is ended, all go in peace. We must diminish and Christ increase. We take him with us wherever we go, that through our actions his life may show. The mass is ended, the mass is ended, I'll go in peace.
Let's pray for the intentions of the Holy Father. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.